Hey, YouTube, this is Vinkin 9, today with...
Thorkar!
And now I have two summons. My clan fail and my winged twilight. I'm gonna call her Tiffany.
So... what is the winged twilight?
So you are the vain fool who seeks to plant. After I kill you, I shall raise you up and make you my slave.
They used to call that thing a harpy.
Used to.
Now hurry, through the portal you go.
Yeah.
That was kind of sad. Then again, my ultimate is kind of very powerful to begin with.
Yeah, your ultimate's broken.
Broken, especially when I go in lightning state and I increase my physical by around 800 or so. So, I have a high power attack and a high freaking defense.
Well, that was fun, wasn't it? The others have all collapsed in their tents. They're exhausted. But I wanted to welcome you back. And so, who knows? Maybe he wants...
Well, I don't think that's the end of Angolf, though. It's
probably
most...
not.
He is a bad guy for this entire island after I did so much stuff with them a few.
The king will be great.
And
without
I have
Angolf,
a feeling that wasn't the end of
the king set aside this army.
Sir. Sir, I... They took him, sir.
Lag.
The captain. We were returning from Daggerfall when our caravan was attacked. Bretons fighting with Daedra at their side.
Killed
Stormhaven.
Ruins. He's immune to poison. I have a feeling he is a true form.
That's the criminal.
Ah! Okay, I'm just gonna run. Did not mean to attack people. Yeah, these people are randomly.
Get away with that?
I love how that one guard just like, nope, not giving a crap. Joy.
If only I could play ESO.
I will no longer be attacked by the law.
Hmm?
I became a outlaw, now I'm notorious.
Ah.
I didn't mean to attack a guard.
Hmm.
That's the thing I don't like with being broken. Yes, so is it's easy as hell to accidentally attack someone that you don't want to attack. Okay, for one, I don't know why that was. Let's go do this real quick to find the guard captain, and then I'm gonna stop the recording right after I get to the quest location. Get off the game, go shopping, and then come back and record some more.
Cool.
I just wanted the boss fight to be the opening for the video. Though I was expecting it to be longer than it was.
Yeah. I mean, that was literally just shot in the crotch. Done.
So you're the fool. No, I'm dead. That's literally what happened, and it was sad. And I'm not even at the level that I'm supposed to be. I'm only level 14, people.
Jeez.
So.
That's just sad.
I'm sure you hate hearing this over and over.
There you go.
I'll bet that was a boss that was nerfed a few times.
I hope he wasn't nerfed. Like, if he was, then I don't know why they nerfed him. Because now they made him just like the easiest boss to defeat. His mini boss before you go there was harder than that. saw it. The guy did, like, a heck of a lot of damage when I was trying to get that stupid stone.
Yeah.
Find the guard, Captain. Oh, new area. Stormhaven. Well, that's good.
I see they kept the Skyrim style of rock modeling. Plenty of handholds and ledges to jump across.
Yeah. Which actually makes sense.
Go! Find the captain!
Yes, I shall find your captain. Then once I find him, I will get off. Laugh.
That makes sense in a way.
Like, it's kind of harder to climb around now than it is Skyrim and all that.
Oh, yeah. They had to change that up.
That was broken as hell.
I know, you got a horse going up a 90-degree cliff. Rather not a 90-degree, more like an 85.
I found Okami's brother, Okoma.
Okami's brother, Okoma. Why, just because he's in a coma or something?
No, just how close the names are.
Ah.
Took a wrong turn in Albuquerque. Come, my minions. We have work to do. Come on, let me just get to where they are and save the guy. Or not save the guy, but realize that the guy is an actual bad guy. That betrayed the five companions.
Wait, the companions were originally the five companions?
It's a different set of companions.
Ah.
It was a group of five that was... Well, I found him.
Damn metal with the supernal dreamers. Taste the flames of oblivion. Go, munchkins. Slash and rend. Why won't you die?
I won't die because I'm not a wimp. Face and then teleported. Here I am just going lightning mode to travel.
Yeah.
Okay, everyone. Got to my destination. I saved the captain. I defeated Angoff, supposedly. I'm gonna stop right here and then we're gonna cut to a different scene later. So, that's the end for the first part. This is gonna be edited to be one part, but...
Yeah.
Just for clearance on why there's gonna be a skip. See you guys in a few. Bye! Okay, everyone. Sorry about that. Bandicam apparently didn't want to work with this, so let's try that again.
Yeah.
But yeah. We were going to... You probably didn't even notice what happened, but... we started recording, and the game decided to crash. Kept a background program running, and a lot of bullshit happened.
Yeah, but we tracked down the goblin and killed it. So hopefully everything will go fine.
Hopefully.
Despite many days of meditating and scrying, Sai-Sahan's
whereabouts strip down and kill these wolves.
The projection that you witnessed, though Sai remains hidden from my sight, Lyris brings news that an agent of the enemy lurks in Daggerfall. Fear is on the lips of the people. If it is truly an agent of Menomarco's worm cult, it may provide us with a clue that will hasten our search. Seek this agent, but tread carefully. Venture to Daggerfall. Speak to Old Maid Maxell.
Oh, that's two wolves down.
Apparently that wasn't the big bad boss of the area.
I've dealt with these worms.
Oh, really?
Because once you get to a high enough level and you have to go as for the main quest, it starts talking about there being one of the worm cultist members.
Oh, God.
In the area. What, the worm cultist?
Yeah, so this is like, what, the original worm cultist war? I mean, what's the era?
The Amulet of Kings is currently lost, if that has any help with figuring out the era.
Well, not really, because there were three times that thing was lost, the last one being the Oblivion Crisis.
It got lost after the covenant that allowed it to keep the realm of... the current realm and the Oblivion realm. The covenant for that got broken.
This way, has the Imperial Empire been established yet?
I think that's what we're on the verge of trying to set up.
Okay. Next question, do any priests talk about the 9, or do they talk about the 8?
I'd have to go to a priest to find out. I think they've been saying the 8.
Then we are before the time of Talos. So the Empire has not been set up. Which means the Amulet of Kings is not exactly the Amulet of Kings right now.
Well, it's neat. Okay, there's 5 companions and a guy that... it's hard to explain. I can't explain it as good as the questline does.
I'm dead.
The Dragonborn have been the kings of the land for a while. This one guy and 5 companions of his basically usurp power and take over the realm. And to try to get Akatosh to adopt him as a dragonborn, one of his men, I think it was like Manikos or something like that.
Manikarmo?
Yeah. Manikarmo tricked him into doing a ritual that broke the covenant on the Amulet of Kings. And Manikarmo is currently partnered with Molag Bol. Does that clear up anything about the era?
Yeah, we are still before the time of Talos.
Okay.
You're new to Daggerfall.
Well, before the time of Talos.
I don't like to gossip. Oh, you're too kind. You make me blush.
Where the hell did all these people pop up at? Oh, a crier just spawned behind me. Oh god, that scared me.
Oh.
And now I'm lagging. Like, what the heck? I wasn't lagging earlier. Probably from the crash. Apparently we're an important figure, and we're having to get back together some of the companions.
Hmm.
Hello there.
Lyris Titanborn, or Lyris Titanborn, however you want to call her name, the half giant person. And right now we're trying to get, I think their name is Sai Sahan.
Who's this now? I bet you've got a wild present company excluded. Sorry, that's all I've...
Sorry if I'm butchering their names, it's kind of... I've had a long day, I'm tired as heck.
Yeah, it's fine.
Now, I'm apologizing to the viewers.
Yeah, but I'm sure they understand.
Saved a king from an assassination plot, yada yada yada.
Yeah, this time we saved the king. I mean, I find it's if you look at Morrowind, Oblivion, and Skyrim, in Morrowind, we meet the Dark Elf Prince. He's a bit of a dick, because he cut his own ears to resemble human ears, because he apparently loves Imperials. We meet his mother, the Queen, Boethia, or whatever the hell you pronounce that queen's name is. She's the one with all the books written about her, everywhere.
Mm-hmm. Mana Marco, I hate you.
Yeah. And so it's kind of funny. In Morrowind, we meet the royal family. Or at least one royal family. In Oblivion, we fail to protect the royal family. They've all been destroyed, Uriel's dead, and lo and behold, we can't even protect his bastard!
Well, his bastard kind of refuses to you at first, anyways.
Yeah. He refuses to accept everything at first, you save his ass, and then get him all the way through the game, only to have him throw his life away at the end. I mean, granted, he saves the world, still.
And his father knew what was gonna happen.
Yeah, because his dad is clairvoyant. And then in this one, the High King is dead.
You mean in Skyrim?
Skyrim, the High King's dead. Yeah, I forgot you're playing a different game than me.
It happens. Where are all my summons? Where are all of you? What are y'all fighting? My summons kind of just abandoned me. That archer was dead! Why the... No logic can announce what bullshit just happened. My summons went back to fight a skeletal archer that I already killed. So I ended up dying because of them.
How dare you trespass here!
That game could have a few issues.
It's expected to have issues.
Yeah, it wouldn't be a game developed by Bethesda without its fair share of bugs.
Hey, I found another maple shield.
I mean, I am complaining about the bugs in Bethesda games, but they do a good job trying to fix most of the game breakers early on. And then if it, yeah, this isn't supposed to happen, but the game still runs fine, and it may fix itself at some point in the future, so we're just gonna leave it alone. I didn't think that. I wish I didn't have that stance.
Had a single friend left, not in this world at any rate. Never fear. Sai Sahan is safely.
It's still funny that
of course I do.
Throughout the last three games, we meet a royal family, lose a royal family, the king is dead, so we're helping to put a new king's candidate into power. It's the Game of Thrones. Up in this shit.
Okay, well, Avner Tharm is an idiot. He's a smart idiot, though.
Huh. For a second there, I thought you were gonna do, it's like, it's a trap!
He's working for Manamarco.
Ah.
Yeah, he claimed earlier, if you remember, to be helping Lyra's Titanborn. Remember that?
Yeah, kinda. And he's actually a bad guy.
We already, in the beginning, say that he's a bad guy. I'm not gonna say where my hand just went, because that was just bad timing. Just a weird coincidence. In the beginning, we state he's a bad guy, but then he appears to come and says he's here to help, and now he's talking with the master, Manamarco, again. Headache. I don't like him. Plain and simple, I just don't like him. Okay, 6 more minutes and then we'll be done for the day. Sheesh.
Oh.
Because we recorded 9 minutes earlier when we went to go do that boss fight that was very pathetic and sad.
Yeah, I was like, oh hey! I'm the boss! Dude cracks to the nuts and he's dead.
2 lightning cracks.
You've returned. What if Abnathan shows his face again? I get the sense that he might have a larger part to play in the coming events, but for good or ill, I cannot.
Hold a moment. Come here. I heard you and the Prophet talking about Abner Tharn. Didn't the Prophet tell you the story of the 5 companions? I don't know where to start. There's so much to tell. We were chosen by Emperor Varen to join him on a quest to recover a lost artifact called the Amulet of Kings. The 5 included Varen, myself, a Red Guard named Sai Sahan, Abner Tharn, and the traitor, Manamarco. You only know him as the man who killed you and stole your soul. But back then, he was Emperor Varen's most trusted advisor. It was Manamarco who convinced... Varen wasn't a true Dragonborn Emperor. He didn't share Alessia's bloodline. Manamarco said the amulet could change all that. He said he could use it to perform a ritual. It took us more than 2 years, but we finally recovered the amulet and returned to Cyrodiil to perform the ritual. Manamarco set us up. Manamarco convinced the Elder Council
to
recognize
Oblivia
as Empress Regent.
Don't you hate it when that happens in Skyrim when you're playing with the hot and cold mod?
Sai Sahan and I went into hiding. There was a bounty on our heads. Abner Tharn is Grand Chancellor of the Elder Council.
And you don't want to go do something, and then you have to, because, look, it's the only way to get warm.
Tharn's first loyalty is to his family and the Empire. And he's a ruthless bastard when it comes to defending them. The Worm Cult obviously doesn't share those loyalties. Maybe. But what could we offer him? We were chosen by Emperor... I know it's a lot to take in.
Oh, well...
I just want to get a full story on what's happening.
Throughout that entire game?
But I know I'm not going to get a complete story until I finish this game.
Yeah, you won't get a complete story for any MMO until you've played both sides of the factions. Well, except for World of Warcraft, because that one was kind of simple. We're fighting you, you're fighting us. Now we're joining up to fight this douchebag over here on this continent.
Well, the funny thing is, they're not really factions, though. Well, we're...
Really,
because
factions?
In the end of all this, I have a feeling that everyone is all fighting Moloch Bol no matter what, regardless.
True.
The main difference between the quest lines is which covenant you're with.
Yeah.
And stuff
like
that.
I still wish we could make guilds that are mercenaries that go intercovenant.
Well, I don't think I'm sworn to the Daggerfall Covenant yet. And later, if you want, you can spend money to make any class, any alliance. Is what I read in one of the help menus.
Hmm.
So later on, you can make a mix. Okay.
I grow tired of winding travels.
Okay, I just recorded a very weird... What the hell? It's like a mini-sun. Someone literally just created the mini-sun. With meteors floating around it, but I just recorded a weird glitch with the texture where it's elevated by a couple feet. I don't think they want that.
Yeah, probably not.
Fogland Village, here I come. Sorry guys, this is probably a boring episode, just watching what the heck is happening, and laughing at my death because my summons are idiots.
Yeah. I wonder what that skill is that one person had where they had the two cats following them.
I don't know, I think that might be something to go with the Khajiits though.
I'm hoping it's something about, like, a neutral skill where you can tame animals. That'd be kind of sweet.
Lucas, can you hear me?
Wow. That was kind of a pointless lock to pick, just a dead-end room with a bunch of iron weapons.
You can sell those weapons, though.
They're too heavy!
Everything's too heavy.
For the price I'd get for them, they're not worth it. If it's not a triple digit, I don't take it.
You're welcome to Koglin Village, traveler, but you'll have to excuse me. No time for idle chat.
Zach, then again, I make most of my money off of selling animal pelts anyway. Of the flame.
I give her credit for a brilliant disguise, but I wasn't born yesterday. Again, a very convenient lie. There was a messenger from the castle here, but he didn't say anything to me.
It's like stamina potions, unless you're the giant ones that don't bother picking them up.
Well, I got the town. Be my guest. Just don't expect any.
Well, time to go save the messenger.
Just shoot the messenger.
No, the messenger was supposed to deliver a specific message, but because he didn't get to deliver that message, someone got wrongfully imprisoned just because of a slaver attack.
I wouldn't feed your corpses to my dog.
Which, funny enough, he got captured during the slaver attack. So now I need to save the messenger to save the Knight of Flame, who has been wrongfully imprisoned.
Filthy Dunmer wine, what are you?
Sounds like a Dunmer.
Hmm? What, the prisoner sounds like a Dunmer?
No, someone just said filthy Dunmer swine.
I assume the Duke sent you? I had a message for the constable.
Well, it wouldn't surprise me if a Dunmer said that. No, they are kind of, stupid like that.
Come on, let me go back out through the doors.
Greetings.
You know what I'd love to do? Filthy Dunmer swine, what are you hiding for? Just try to get out of there. I dare you. Corpses to my dog.
Oh. There's a Dunmer.
Filthy Dunmer swine. I wouldn't feed your corpses to my dog.
Any sign of those slavers?
Why, the Dunmer said filthy Dunmer swine?
No, there's some weird warden girl.
This young man is lucky to be alive.
Yeah. So what about armor options? Do you still have cloth armor, which is zero armor? Then light, medium, heavy.
My duty is to ensure the safety of this village.
Think cloth
my gut's
is now
telling me
under
that
light,
she's part of the threat. Too many coincidences. But if we can get the village, the slavers are on board. The captain claims he's not with them, but I know the truth. He's asking me to send the town guard to help him clear the slavers from below. He's
ooh,
not,
that's big orc.
But even if he was, you do that.
Okay, you don't trust the captain? Fine, I'll go clear out the slavers from below his below decks myself. How do I get on a ship?
Are you still in the tutorial zone, or?
No.
Wow.
It's just I don't, because different ships have different paths to get on it.
Oh, different ships have different docks.
Constable says be ready.
Because some of them have multiple paths. Sooner like,
it was a daring battle.
You go on the left side,
yes.
The other go on the right
you
side.
You are brave.
Some perhaps you have even to find a way to jump on board.
Oh. That system.
Yeah. As soon as I try to leave, I'm gonna get attacked.
Hello.
Go back to your homes. You'll be much safer there.
What if we're expecting cargo? Yeah. What should we
greetings.
Do?
The captain still refuses to leave? You have the ship's ledger? The captain said it was lost below decks. I'll have to study this, but I'll be... No, I'm sorry. We just can't take that risk. I dreamed about all of this, you see. The slavers, the ship, the knights.
Go!
Yes, Sabisa the blacksmith,
that
too.
That guy square
I don't
in
care
chest.
How it sounds. Defending the village is the highest priority, and we need weapons for that.
At least my live streamers
actually,
will be happy to hear.
Didn't.
I'm no longer shooting them in the crotch.
First, but I must admit, I am beginning to question your intentions. You don't know what you're
doing. This constable is paranoid as hell.
Oh?
He's having random people arrested because he thinks they're working with the slavers. Including a blacksmith that's been with the village for years.
Wow. What a douche.
I think he's just being paranoid as heck.
Well, no crap.
If Constable Pascal sent you here with orders to open the forge, you can just turn around and head right back out the door. That man has no right to order... Arrest me? That beef-witted bastard! To think I even cooked that man breakfast. We were friends for years, and then one night... Well,
we were friends for years, and then
the
one
details.
Night... Well, I guess you don't need details.
For a month or two, I thought we had something. Then he just broke it off. Wouldn't he... He did? He was having trouble sleeping. You know, I saw one of those weird cult members leaving his house. The Supernal Dreamers. Good idea.
I know what's going on now.
What?
There's a group of Supernal Dreamers, and one of them was spotted leaving the constable's house one night.
Hmm.
Which means... Da-da-da-da! Tampered with. Dreams being tampered.
Oh, for eight's sake. Guards!
Really? Where's a guard when I need one? Have to kill that guy. Guy literally didn't. I don't even know how he saw me, but apparently he saw me. Started calling for the guards.
You.
There's no talking yourself out of this one.
You.
Yep. Paid my bounty. I'm backed up standing.
Ooh, silver. That's a good mine.
Oh, that was lucky. I had a 15% chance for my force pick to work.
Huh. So you forced the lock.
Yep, and the 15% worked.
Nice.
With only 50% chance, it worked.
Yeah.
I'm happy. Okay, one of the Supernal Dreamers had put a Daedric artifact in the guy's bed and was able to cause the guy to go chaotic in the mind. Hence why he's so paranoid and is willing to even arrest his best friend, who he slept with.
Turns out that almost everyone in... Oh, my poor little Pascal. What a mess you... Indeed, as I said.
Yep.
Oh, great. I have to take on the Pale Lady.
I am your constable.
As Wisp Mother.
I haven't been this sore in years. Oh, but Freedom sure does not as glad as I am, believe me. It seems I'll need to take over security here in the village. And with those slavers out there, I need to get busy. First, though, I'm gonna see if some... The villagers may not realize it, but you saved this town from crumbling into chaos. I mentioned before that I came from Alcair. Good question.
Okay, everyone, thank you for watching. This is Pinkin 9.
And Torker.
Thanks, see you later and have a good one. Bye.